Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. Now, it's been since last night. I've been trying to make the video praying for people. Last night, the Lord arrested me with a video, and then today, I continued that, and then I accidentally cut off that video, but let's just go on with the next one. I'm going to pray for people now. Anyway, I wanted to tell you guys the website's going. You know, we keep adding to it, and right now, we've added the prayer request link, plus some other stuff. We're getting it going. And I just invite you guys to go on their different prayer requests. There are people who are praying for these different things. And then there's brothers and sisters who are going to be working with different topics. We still have to add more topics. If you have a topical request of prayer or counseling that is not on there, please email. Brother Sid is on there. Sidney or Sid at churchfirstborn.com. He's on the link of those people in these different areas. He's the one. You can email him, and then he will. He and I will get together and pray about it. We're looking for people. As I mentioned, there's other topics, too. If you feel led by the Lord to work in a different area or different topic, to minister to people, as an example, abused women or whatever. Whatever, as I mentioned before, women that's had an abortion or who are thinking of getting an abortion, things like that. Please message Brother Sidney on the website, Church of Firstborn. The link is below here. Tell him, you know, your testimony, and then he's going to give it to me, and we'll look at it. We'll communicate with you, and we'll pray about it and put you in that spot if you're maturing the Lord to do that, to handle that, you know. You have to be mature enough to help other people, you know. As a matter of fact, suppose you had been abused. You came out of an abusive relationship. Then you know, you're a Christian. You've been a Christian for many years, and you know, and you're maybe you want to help. It's usually younger women, you know. Maybe you're a little bit older. You want to, or way older, or even a little bit older. You want to help younger women to, you know, to figure out what to do in their situation of abuse and things like that. Be glad to have you. We need those people. I know the Lord will provide the people that we need. And those of you who are not, I ask you to pray that God will provide someone to be a personal, you know, counselor, you know, and then I'm the backup on all of these counselors. This is an opportunity for those counselors to be discipled to a higher level. I mean, ultimately, you know, the church is not a one-man show, which most churches are. All churches, basically, organized churches are a one-man show when we are called, you know, to be the body and we work together. And then you have overseers. Preachers are supposed to be overseers, elders, to make sure no one's teaching false doctrine and the wolves aren't eating the sheep and all that kind of stuff. But ultimately, besides that, you know, and then some are called to teach, and some are called to be prayer warriors, some are called to be worship leaders and singers and all that different kind of stuff. So we are a team. That's what I was going to say, Joshua's ministry, which is really, that's the ministry from the Philippines, but the Church of the Firstborn, Joshua's ministry, the mission that the Lord gave me was to bring together people and let everyone be used by the Lord to their maximum capacity. And those who are trying to do it in their own flesh, who are not called by God for to do something, you know, me as an overseer, as the servant of God, would call them down and say, hey, you want to be, you know, some kind of a leader in the body of Christ, but first you need to be a follower. And then those are people who are hiding and following who should be leaders, you know, and that's the mission, you know, that part of my mission is to help you get in the right spot. And that's really the definition of what a New Testament prophetic ministry is all about. Helping people find out their destiny and walk therein in the right timing, the right place, and the right people. You know, you just like, as an example, you take a fish, out of water, lay it on the sand, he's going to be flopping around like he can't do anything. He's just like useless other than to eat, cook it and eat it. Put the fish in the water, and there he is. He's in the right place, you know, in the right time. So we all have our place to be, a fish in water, and then lots of people are like a fish out of water. And that's the purpose of, one big purpose of my ministry is to help Christians. That's, you know, how, because the mission of Joshua's ministry or the Church of the Firstborn is to prepare the bride to meet the Lord. So how can we do, well, you know, what do we do to prepare to meet the Lord? We get in the right place at the right time with the right people, doing the right thing. God's will in our life. You know, and lots of people are not in God's will. You know, the average story that I get is, well, the Lord, you know, spoke to me when I was 18, but I decided to do my own will. You know, I married the wrong person. I took the wrong job. I did this, I did that, knowing that God didn't want me to. And now here I am 40, 50, 60 years old, 70 years old. And I just, you know, now I've decided God woke me up in 2011. And I know that the rapture is soon. And I'm in the wrong spot. And how do I get back to point A, or what can I do? And some people are standing back there staring at the past saying, I'm going to try to go back and redo it and all that. And other people are just saying, well, I can't do anything about it, so it's too late. But God can move you, not backwards, back in time, even though I guess he could do that too. But God can move you to the right place through doorways that you least expect. And he can move, you know, close doors that you least expect. He can close doors in your face, and he can open doors in your face that no man can shut, and shut doors that no man can open. And that's how God works. And that's what I'm here for, brothers and sisters. You know, besides teaching you how to praise and worship like I did in the last two videos, the Lord had led me to teach you about, you know, how to get real with God, how to be a John 3:16, not an Austin 3:16. Don't be stone cold, but have a heart of a soft heart, a circumcised fleshly heart for the Lord, and not a stone cold Steve Austin heart. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to pray for our people now by the grace of God. The Lord will let me. I've already asked the Lord since last night, Lord, you're going to let me pray for these people. And the Lord keeps stopping me. I tried to do some, and I just wasn't getting much. I mean, I was, but I was like, I don't think this is right. I mentioned last night in my video that I'm not loading, I guess, Sister Holly, Sister Lucy, and I think there was one more I'd circled. I don't know if Marcy was one I'd circled. Her name is next. Anyway, the Lord had me circle their name to give them more. I ask you guys to pray for Sister Holly. She makes videos. She's on here, I think. I don't know if she uses her last name on her YouTube channel, but she's Holly West Virginia, or WV, I think it is, on Facebook. And then she makes YouTube videos about her dreams. She's had some good dreams from the Lord. Anyway, I'd given a word for her the other day on a video I made about an abdominal x-ray of hers. And then I didn't know what it meant. It's something to do with her abdomen. Something they had found or whatever, and then she had messaged, you know, commented on the video that was true. She had some kind of abdominal scan, and they found something there, and she was waiting on the results. So I asked you guys to pray for Sister Holly, and I believe that God causes all things to work together for the good of those who love him, who are called according to his purposes. That's the word of the Lord for you, Sister Holly, right now. The Lord is speaking to me. You will survive. You know, I've been waiting to hear from the Lord. I can't say it if the Lord doesn't tell me. And the Lord just told me, you will survive. You will survive, Sister Holly. However, I got this little tiny speaker called, a little bullet. It's called a bullet, so I can do my praise and worship. I'm trying to charge it. I just kicked it over. But I thought it was something else. It's just a speaker. Anyway, so the Lord is saying, you will survive, Sister Holly. Praise the Lord for that. So I don't know any more details than that. People don't understand how God works. God doesn't give you all the details. He gives you something. As an example, like Joseph had the dreams of that his, like I say, you guys need to read the Bible. In Genesis, Joseph, the son of Jacob, he had a dream. And Jacob is the son of Isaac. Isaac is the son of Abraham. He had a dream. And in his dream, he saw his parents and his brothers bowing down to him when he was a teenager. Now, what happened is God didn't show him that that would be like 20 or 30 years later, you know, when he had become sold into slavery. He was thrown into a cistern by his brothers. Go Google that if you don't know what it means. Then they were going to kill him, and then they decided one of the brothers is like tried to save him and said, well, I think it's Judah, or maybe it was the oldest one. Or Judah said, well, you know, let's sell him into slavery, you know, so they wouldn't kill him. And they did. And then he was taken by the Ishmaelites, and he was made into this prison, and then he was sold as a slave. And then this guy Potiphar, who was a big wheel there with the Pharaoh, he made him the chief of staff of his house, the head of his household, because God was preparing him to be, you know, the right-hand man of Pharaoh. He went through that process. And then he was falsely accused of rape because he refused to have sex with Potiphar's wife as she tried to be a cougar mama on him. She tried to cougar mama him, and it didn't work. You know, I should do videos of, you know, the Bible for the Kardashian Facebook, the Kardashian crowd. a Kardashian's version of the Bible, you know, for pop culture, simple-minded people who have no sense of history, no sense of the Bible at all, and, you know, put it in terms they can understand. So Potiphar's wife tried to cook her mama, Joseph, and Joseph was sold into, put into prison, falsely accused of trying to be a baby's mama. And in that process, he became the head of all the stuff in the prison. Everything he touched, everything he did was like, did great. His administrative skills were God, all from God, supernatural. So then he interpreted some dreams of the butler and the baker who were in prison. Then the butler reminded, he told the Pharaoh about it when the Pharaoh had his dream, and Joseph was exalted to the right hand of Pharaoh. So in this case, Pharaoh, unlike the Pharaoh with Moses, the Pharaoh with Moses is a type of the Antichrist. This Pharaoh is a type of the father, and Joseph is a type of the son. So you can't always, people know a little bit of the Bible or are cardinal-minded, they can't think spiritually. God, just as I mentioned in the last video, the video I made about Stone Cold Steve Austin and all that, John 3:16, go in, you have to be, I think I'm going to call it, I'm getting ready to load it after this, with this one, you must be the right 3:16 to be raptured. So just like I said in there, God uses duality. There are things that represent evil and things that represent good, and the same thing is used by God, and it's also used for evil, different ways. It depends. God uses duality, and then the devil perverts it, on and on and on at all these different layers, as the Bible is an onion. Many, many, many layers, brothers and sisters, and God takes us deeper and further into his wisdom. Anyway, so Joseph didn't know that he was going to go through all those things before he was exalted to the right hand of Pharaoh. God didn't tell him that. God showed him the gravy without showing him the cooking process. He saw the finished gravy, but he didn't see the process it takes to make the gravy, the flesh. Hey, this is the Lord is just dropping all this cool stuff on me. I can, you know, there's people that, you know, you can really preach on this. When you're going to make gravy, of course, that flesh has to be cooked, right? You got to heat that flesh up, cook all the fat out of it, you know, and get all the grease out of it, and then you use that to make the gravy. But the flesh has to be cooked. It has to be processed before you get to the gravy. See, this is my saying Kardashian. I got to think of a better name for it, the Kardashian version of the Bible. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord just keeps making me preach and giving me all this cool stuff to say because I'm trying to pray for people. So I'm trying my best. Sister Holly, you will survive, as I said. Praise God for that. Sister Lucy, Father, in the name of Jesus. And the Lord is just speaking to me about being loosed. I know your name is Lucy. And then the Lord is just speaking to me to be loosed. You'll be let loose from whatever that is. Freedom, liberty, being loosed. Just like Joseph was free from the prison, you'll be set loose in Jesus' name. Sister Marcy. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for Sister Marcy right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Lord, we thank you for your spirit of holiness, of righteousness. Hallelujah. Of love unfeigned. Blessed be the name of the Lord God Most High. We thank you, Father, for your blessings, and we pray for Sister Marcy right now in Jesus' name. I hear that the wealth of the Lord is your strength. The wealth of the Lord is your strength. That's the word that the Lord told me. Now, you know, wealth can be lots of things, but I believe it also includes money. Wealth, I mean, you got some kind of a financial trouble, whatever, but the Lord, you know, has all the Bible says God has the gold, you know, cattle on a thousand hills and all the gold of the earth and all this stuff. It all belongs to God. You know, God gives it to whom he wills. He, you know, Jesus even had Peter to go when they were going to pay a temple tax. He told Peter, go cast your net, and the first fish you pull out, open its mouth, and there will be a 5-drachma gold coin in his mouth. God can do all things, Sister Marcy, and God has all the wealth. He will provide for you the wealth that you need. God's going to make a way for you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for the word for Sister Marcy. Linda. Sister Linda, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Linda. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. We pray for Sister Linda right now. And I just keep hearing the word light. Light of the world. Be a light of the world, Sister Linda. I think that's the word I even got last night when I tried to make this video. You know, I tried to make this video. I got through about the first 5 or 6 names, and then I just wasn't getting too much. So, Sister Linda, I got the same word twice for you. Be a light in the world. The Lord wants you to be a light. In other words, don't hold back talking about him, giving the gospel, you know, setting a good example. Don't grow weary in well doing. Don't stop, you know, demonstrating the love of Christ and the gospel of Christ, living the gospel of Christ in front of people that you're tired of dealing with. That's probably what the Lord is referring to. Shona, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Shauna. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. Seems like every one of these names right now, the Lord is giving me like a word that's similar to their name. You know, the Lord will do that to you. He gets in a pattern. He'll use a pattern on you. So, Shauna, I keep hearing the word sickness. Sickness. And this sickness is not unto death. The sickness is not unto death, but to obtain salvation through Jesus Christ. So if it's you or one of your relatives, somebody's sick, this not unto death, but to obtain salvation in Jesus Christ. So God is using this for His glory. All things work together for the good of those who love God, who are called according to His purposes. God will use this sickness to bring salvation in Jesus' name. But and the person is, if it's you or another person, they're not going to die, but it's unto salvation. So they will live. Praise God for that. Brother Patrick. Patrick. Well, I'm Patrick, but this is for another Patrick. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we thank you for Brother Patrick. And he's got a cool name, Lord, so we know that he must be smart. And Lord, we ask you to bless him in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you in the name of Jesus. Father, we praise you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Lord, we just speak your grace and mercy. I keep seeing a vision of this guy who I used to know. I don't remember his name, but he wore glasses like me. So that's what I keep seeing. This guy's got glasses. But I used to know when I was in the Army. I can't think of his name. I don't think his name was Patrick. I don't know. But I just pray right now for you, Brother Patrick, in Jesus' name. And I would ask you, which I haven't asked anybody this, but I believe maybe the Lord wants me to speak, you know, to chat with you. So send me a message, Brother Patrick, and let's chat. I think that's what the Lord is meaning by this, that I would need to know you, okay? Let's talk. Message me, okay, and tell me more. Let's talk. Okay, Brother Luke. There's a Luke. Luke, trust the force. No, that's not from the Lord. Sorry. I'm sorry, brothers and sisters, but you know, when the Lord is, you know, sometimes the Lord just gives you a spirit of joy, you know. And so, Luke, I pray for you right now in Jesus' name. Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. We pray for Brother Luke. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I just hear someone speaking in tongues, Brother Luke. I hear someone speaking in tongues. So I don't know if that's what you're seeking or you do speak in tongues. Either way, the Lord wants you to be baptized in the Holy Spirit if you're not. And then the thing is that the Lord wants you to pray in the Spirit. That's what the Lord is telling me. He wants you to pray in the Spirit. And that means praying in tongues in your own private prayer language to the Lord, not requiring interpretation. Pray to the Lord in private and praying in the Spirit, building up your most holy faith, praying in the Spirit. Brother Luke, let me stop here and go to the front because these are the names I got later. I've added, these are the latest names I've got. I need to come back to the first names that I've got. Let's start with Michelle. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I pray for Sister Michelle right now. And the Lord is speaking to me what he told me last night, a spirit of wisdom. See, I mean, this is a good confirmation because I went through like 5-10 names last night, and I just got one word for lots of these people. Sister Michelle, wisdom. The spirit of wisdom of the Lord is upon you to show his strength to the feeble-minded. Lord, we use you to show his strength to the feeble-minded through wisdom, spirit of wisdom. Hallelujah, Wendy. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Sister Wendy. Hallelujah. And the Lord has given me Mark chapter 11, verse 22, 23, and 24. You know, and the Lord is saying that, you know, whosoever saying to this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, shall not doubt in his heart, but believes those things he saith, he shall have those things he saith. That's 23, Mark 11, 23, verse 22. I have faith in God. So go back, Sister Winnie, and read that text. So this is the text that the Lord wants you to read and focus on about, you know, saying to this mountain, you know, be cast in the sea and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe those things he say shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he saith. Go back and read that. Mark 11, 22, 23, and 24. Wendy, and all of you guys who are lacking faith, and, you know, you're trying to break through and get something, you know, an answered prayer, go read that text. That's the one. You need to keep repeating that and get it in your spirit about whatever you sayeth. the word the Lord repeats the most in that text is saith. You say it. Faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word of God. You keep saying the word of God, the promises of God. Then it's going right back into your ear. You're building up your own faith by repeating it. Don't speak doubt and unbelief over your prayer request, but keep declaring the victory you have in the promises of God, standing on the promises of God. Nikki, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Nikki, Lord God. We speak your blessings upon her. Lord, I just declare victory for Nikki right now in Jesus' name. The Lord said he's given you the victory. And I see an army of, you know, it's like the enemy. I see that the enemy is, you know, this army of the enemy has been trying to attack you or is trying to attack you. And God's going to give you the victory, Nikki, over this evil, you know, this army of evil attacks against you. God's given you the victory, Sister Nikki. You've got the victory through Christ Jesus. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. That's what the word of the Lord gave me for you last night, too. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Sister Crystal. Sister Crystal. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask all you guys to pray in agreement with me for Sister Crystal. Hallelujah, Father. We give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for Sister Crystal right now, Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And I just see someone, it's like a New Age thing, someone sitting in one of those, the lotus position or whatever, some yoga position with her, some kind of a guru thing. And I don't know, Sister Crystal, if you're dealing with in your own life or around you this New Age stuff, some kind of a false doctrine, New Age kind of stuff. I believe and pray that the Lord, that your name also will be true, that it'll be crystal clear to you what is truth and what is a lie, that God will set you free. Are you, or someone in your family, maybe it's not just necessarily you, but are people around you, you know, sometimes the Lord is very specific and tells me, hey, it's this person, and I try to not to say unless I know 100% sure. I mean, that's why I say maybe it's one of your relatives and maybe it's you. You know, that God will make it crystal clear to you what is truth and what is a lie. And I ask everyone to pray in agreement with me for this and for all the prayers I gave for people like Sister Holly, all the people that we prayed. Let's pray, brothers and sisters, in agreement for these people's names I give, the word from the Lord. And because God gives us a word, because he's, you know, just like he changed Abraham's name from Abram to Abraham. He changed his name to Father of Many Nations when he had no children. So God calls those things that are not as if they are. So when God speaks, it's like, that's why it's prophetic. He calls those things that are not as if they are. So I'm saying, you know, I'm saying by the Spirit of God that crystal, that the truth will be crystal clear. So your name, Crystal, is, you know, prophetic in itself, that it's crystal clear to you and to those people in your family, your friends, your vicinity that you're dealing with, the people you're dealing with, that it will become crystal clear to them. And you will be able to deliver truth, receive truth, and deliver truth to others. Lynette. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, I pray for Sister Lynette. I asked you guys, too, to comment on this video like the last ones. People have been commenting, and I asked those who don't believe in that God speaks to people and all that kind of stuff, go back and look at the comments. Lots of people private messaged me, but several people publicly commented on the video, the word that I gave them. Even there's a child who got a word, and I think it was Joshua. There's two brothers, and one of them is Joshua, I think. I'm sorry, I'm bad with names. It takes me forever to catch up to remember these things. But anyway, one of those boys, he's a child, and the word I gave was something he had secretly been thinking about and praying about, you know. And that's how God is. He reveals the thoughts and intents of our heart, because that we will know individually, the person he's talking to and everyone else, that hey, God is real. God is real. God knows everything. God knows everything. God knows all things. It builds up our faith and it helps people get in the right direction and people to be sustained through the valley. As I talked about Joseph, Joseph's vision gave him the faith to endure the pit before he got to the palace. He did his time in the pit before he went to the palace. And he saw the mountaintop. You know, he saw the mountaintop of his seated at the right hand of Pharaoh. You know, just like, you know, Martin Luther King, all, you know, before he was assassinated, he gave his famous mountaintop speech, famous mountaintop preaching. He saw the mountaintop. God let him see the mountaintop, you know, the end of Jim Crow laws and segregation. And so that's what motivated him and gave him the faith to go, even that he even already, you know, mentioned many times he wasn't fearing any man. And, you know, he had a prophetic word from the Lord and insight that he was going to be killed. But yet he said he was fearing no man because he had been to the mountaintop, even though I might not get there with you, just like Moses. But I've been to the mountaintop, and it turned out to be, you know, so prophetically true, you know, words of knowledge, words of wisdom that, as an example, as I just said, Martin Luther King had. God had given him those visions, words, however he received it from God in his spirit to motivate him and sustain him. And that's the same thing God did with Joseph. And that's the same thing God will do with you. He shows you that mountaintop. He shows you where, just like Abraham, he changed his name and started saying, hey, father of many nations. Abraham had no children. And God said, hey, father of many nations. Every time you say Abraham, you're saying father of many nations. His wife said, hey, come in here, father of many nations. You know, so it sustained him and motivated him from the time he was 75 when he first heard it from God until it was 25 years later when he was 100 that Isaac was born. God sustained him by that. And then when God told him to offer Isaac as a living sacrifice, he already knew that Isaac was the promise. God had already told him Isaac was the promise. He'd be the father of many nations. And through his seed, Isaac, the whole world would be blessed. All the nations would be blessed. His descendants would be like the sand of the sea, if you could count the sand on the sea. So when Abraham heard that, those things sustained him through God telling him to sacrifice his son. As it tells us in Jude, Abraham thought, well, he did receive Isaac back from the dead. Isaac was resurrected figuratively. He was as good as dead, and then he was raised, also symbolic of Christ. But yet, and in Jude, or in, was it in Jude that I'm quoting from? I think so. I'm jumping all over the place. I believe it's in Jude. It says that he received him, it's Hebrews chapter 11. Anyway, so, yes, Hebrews chapter 11, sorry about that. Anyway, so Abraham received him back from the dead figuratively, and then it says in there that Abraham, you know, knew in his mind that, hey, if I'm going to literally stab him and kill him, God's going to have to resurrect him and bring him back because God made these promises, A, B, C, you know, of all what the things I just said. So a word from the Lord can sustain you through the valley, and that's what it's all about. God wants to encourage you and show you his future for you, and then it's your job to get there, to walk by faith, you know, and keep pressing through till you get there, where God has shown you where you're supposed to be, whether it be a missionary in the Philippines. You know, it takes a lot of process to become a missionary in the Philippines. I mean, you know, whatever. The Lord probably wants you to go to school. You know, you got to have funding. You got to have money. You got to have all the things. You have to have contacts. You have to have connections. You have to have cultural, cross-cultural communication skills. All these things are developed, some through training, some through schooling and all that. You have to develop all that kind of stuff. Your maturity in the Lord, how to deal with people, how to minister, learning a foreign language, all that kind of stuff. It's a process. It's a lot of valley going on to get to that mountaintop of doing God's will. All right. The Lord is leading me to teach and preach, brothers and sisters. And, I'm not trying to give you a fish, but I'm trying to teach you how to fish so you can eat every day. That's the whole mission of the Church of the Firstborn, is teach you how to fish, not to feed you every day, just a little tiny, you know, and exalt the pastor as, you know, it's all about, you know, the people even on YouTube, the biggest guy on YouTube. There are people that basically almost worship this dude and idolize him. If anybody says anything negative about them, woo, they just attack and call you names and all this stuff. It's only a man. People are only human. And people need to stop exalting and idolizing people. Like in these big churches and all that, you know. Even Billy Graham, who's a very humble guy. Billy Graham Ministries. John Hagee Ministries. You know, they got their name up there. Anyway. But as I say, you know, from outward appearance, Billy Graham is, you know, by his fruit, he seems to be a very humble man. Unlike the rest of them, you know, he's one of the few. Caroline. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Sister Caroline right now, Lord. We pray for your grace to be upon her, your wisdom right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just decree right now in the name of Jesus. I just keep hearing the word grace. His grace is sufficient for you. His grace is enough. The grace of the Lord will shine down upon you. That's what I hear for you, Caroline. His grace is enough for you. His grace is enough for you. And I see that, you know, the Lord would bless you. And I see you at the marriage supper of the Lamb, Sister Caroline. His grace is enough for you. So, you know, maybe you're doubting your salvation or what. I don't know all the details of that. But the Lord is telling me to tell you His grace is enough, and I saw you at the marriage supper of the Lamb. Praise God for that. Gary H. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Brother Gary H. The Lord is telling me a Bible verse. It's like the least of these among you. Let the least of these among you. You know, when Jesus talked about having a banquet and all that, you invite even the least among you. So the Lord is, that's the word the Lord gave for me, and I don't know exactly what direction is going in. But hear from the Lord that it's the least, let the least among you. I don't know. This, the least among you, is what I'm hearing from the Lord for Brother Gary H. Ray New, Brother Ray New. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for Brother Ray New right now. I also see about praying in the Spirit, being baptized with the Holy Spirit, speaking in tongues for Ray New. Same thing. You need to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, and you need to speak, pray in the Spirit. That's for you also. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for Sister Patricia right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. The Lord is telling me, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Sister Patricia, hallelujah. Sister Julia C., Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for Sister Julia C. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory right now. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father, I pray for Sister Julia C. right now. Hallelujah. And the Lord is just showing me that your flesh has been through the process, as I mentioned, I think, in this video earlier. Your flesh has been processed, and you are ready for the gravy. You're ready to reap. You know, you are ready to be in the position like Joseph. I mean, you're ready to be. God has prepared you, and you are ready to be in the position that God called you to. You've already been processed to the point, and you're ready to walk in the calling of God in your life. You're already there. You're ready. God bless you. You're ready to walk in the calling that God gave you. Sister Gloria. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Gloria. We pray for Sister Gloria right now in the name of Jesus. The Lord is telling me Acts of the Apostles. Acts of the Apostles in Jesus' name. Acts of the Apostles. Those people I talked about praying in the Spirit and all that, I remember last night. Those two people that I mentioned. Rainew is one, and I forgot who the other person is, about praying in the Spirit. The Lord told me last night when I read your names, you need to read Acts chapter 2. Read Acts chapter 2. Read Acts chapter 2. Rainew and the other person, and Gloria, the Lord is telling me Acts. And I assume it's also referring to the book of Acts. You need to read that. The Acts of the Apostles. Sister Gloria, the Lord wants you to read Acts. Those other two, specifically Acts chapter 2, that's Rainew and I can't remember the other person who I said about praying in the Spirit. That was one of the first people I prayed for. Forgot now, it's back in the beginning. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I might stop right there with this so far, with this list. So I know that I finished this section right here. I'll come back to you guys, the rest of you guys. You know, I still got lots of names here. I'm sorry, guys. I just, you know, I got to stop sometimes and renew, try again tomorrow. Maybe I can make it tomorrow. I'm getting ready to go do this exorcism and all that kind of stuff and minister to a whole bunch of people. And then some people who are former drug addicts, too, are trying to stop, trying to become former drug addicts, I think, who I ministered to last time I was here. And then tomorrow I'll be going to this home Bible church, and then I think with some homeless people, we'll be ministering to them too. Former homeless people are still maybe. Anyway, that home church is trying to do a ministry to homeless people here. So I don't know if I'll do something with that or not tomorrow if we have time. Anyway, God bless you guys. I'm praying for you. I'm sorry the rest of the people. I'm still working on it. Still working on the list. God bless.